Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 94th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Crew 9.
One, ignition, full power, and liftoff. Crew 9, go SpaceX, go Falcon, go NASA.
Lift off of Crew 9.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1085, then landed successfully for the second time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1. SpaceX posted some information about the Crew 9 launch. They said Crew 9 is the first human spaceflight mission to launch from Pad 40. SpaceX posted some information about a slight mishap with the second stage that will result in a small delay to their launch schedule. They said after today's successful launch of Crew 9, Falcon 9's second stage was disposed in the ocean as planned but experienced an off-nominal deorbit burn. As a result, the second stage safely landed in the ocean but outside of the targeted area. We will resume launching after we better understand root cause. There's been some interesting information from NASA about Dragon. This post says Crew Dragon now has an extra safety feature enabled. If all parachutes fail, Crew Dragon will land propulsively using its Super Draco engines. There was some information posted about Air France and Starlink. This article says Air France announced plans September 26 to begin rolling out free Starlink broadband services across its entire fleet in the summer, becoming the latest major airline to partner with SpaceX. Heading to Boca Chica, excavation was seen going on for the orbital Pad B flame trench. Work continues on Starhopper with its skin now fully removed. Work is continuing on the parking garage in the production yard. There was some sort of party going on recently in Mega Bay 2. RGV Aerial Photography posted a cool aerial photo of Booster 11's remains sitting at Massey's test site. They said Booster 11's engine section at Massey's after being recovered from the Gulf of Mexico. Here's the boat that was carrying the recovered pieces of Booster 11 arriving in port. SpaceX posted some cool pictures of Booster 12 and engineers sitting on the chopstick catching arms. They said SpaceX engineers have spent years preparing and months testing for the booster catch attempt on Flight 5, with technicians pouring tens of thousands of hours into building the infrastructure to maximize our chances for success. Scaffolding is being reassembled around Ship 31 for some further work. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.